Hey guys, it's Becky with Design Bundles, and today we are going to teach you about fonts in Silhouette Studio. So one of the most requested tutorials is covering fonts with glyphs, and even though it is a designer edition upgrade, we are going to show you how to work on a PC the easy way and the original way, just in case you still have basic edition. And then it'll be up to you if you decide that it's worth the upgrade or not. But glyphs are a really fun accessory for fonts, and with all the gorgeous fonts available from fontbundles.com, this is a really, really awesome tutorial that you do not want to miss, and it'll help you take your crafting to the next level.
Okay guys, so here we are on fontbundles.net, and what I wanted to show you is how to identify a font that has glyphs available for you to use. Now this one in particular, I really love it. Not only because of the look, but because it comes with glyphs and it comes with different ornamental icons that you can use to enhance your designs also. So what you want to look for is usually they will tell you, now let me scroll up just a little bit, that it has the illustrations, and they'll usually use some flourishes in the main cover. And then you should be able to scroll through and get an example of a few different types of glyphs that are going to be available. Now, fontbundles.net is a really great place to find glyphs. If you're more of a fan of free fonts, usually free fonts are not going to have the glyphs because of how demanding they are on the font designer. So, you know, definitely know that purchasing these fonts with glyphs is 110% worth it, because you can tell the detail and extra time that they put into creating and programming these fonts to the work the way that we need them to. Now I've already purchased this font, so I'm going to go ahead and jump on over to Silhouette Studio, and this font will be there for us to play with. Now in Silhouette Studio, the first thing that we're going to do is just type out a text. So we can type out any text that we want. Let's type out hello. There we go. We'll make it a little bit bigger, and I'm going to fill this in just for the purpose of you guys being able to see it better. Now I'm going to open my text style panel. Now this is the easy way. This is part of the introduction where I was explaining this part is a designer edition feature. So that means you have to have designer edition or higher in Silhouette Studio, but don't worry. Just hold on if you only have basic edition, because I am going to show you the not so easy way, but free way to take care of this also. So we're going to open the textile panel, and here is your glyphs icon. So we can select any font that we want. I am going to select the font that we looked at. Here we go. And this font in particular also comes with the ornamental font. So that is not the font where the glyphs are for the font itself, but that is extras that you'll be able to use if you choose to. So what we're going to do, a lot of times the extra characters will be down at the bottom. So if you scroll down a little bit, you'll start to see what all of these are. They're loading so that you can preview them. And this is a pretty decent sized preview in Silhouette Studio to be able to make your choice. So what I want to do, a lot of times when you're working with glyphs, it's going to be the beginning and the end of your font, or your text rather. So I'm going to scroll up to the H's. I went a little bit too far. So there we go. Definitely getting closer. Okay, and here we go. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to double click on my text, and that's going to open it up to be edited. And I can delete that H, and I can then replace it with any H I choose. And it inserts the glyph right there for me to use. Now I can repeat the same with the O. I just want to take the O out, come back down here and locate the O's. And this one, like I said, is just a really awesome font. So I have several choices to choose from. I can hover over them to get a little bit bigger preview. And then I just choose the one that I want. Now, once that is taken care of, you will just treat this like you do regular text. What that means, you can size it. You can still switch out the characters if you want to. And once you're ready, or have finished your design, you can weld these together. That way they will not cut into each other. So the way you would do that is you would just right click and choose weld. And literally that design is complete. There's nothing else that needs to be done. So now let's talk about how we would achieve the same results, but with using the character map on PC. Okay, so if you do not have Designer Edition, that is fine because we can still do this. It'll just be a few more extra steps to take care of. First, you want to locate your character map and go ahead and open it up on your computer. Once the character map appears, you'll see that you still have access to all the extra and special characters. Okay, to narrow them down, sometimes what you'll need to do is go to character set and choose Unicode, group by Unicode subrange, and then scroll down to the bottom and private use characters. Okay, now I'm not saying that all of your glyphs are going to be contained here, but a lot of times that's the quickest way to locate them. So you'll notice if I click on any of these, I get a very small preview of what that glyph is going to look like. So what I would do is I would click on one that I wanted to use. Let's see. Let's choose a different word this time. Here we go. So let's choose, I want a T. Let's locate one. I like that one. Okay, so what I'll do is I will hit select and it will copy that character down here at the bottom. Now I also know that I need an E. Let's see how far up we have to go. There's the E's. So let's select that one. Okay, now with those input here, I'm gonna hit copy. I can minimize my character map, go ahead and start a new text, and hit paste. I use the keyboard shortcut, which is Control V. And if I blow this up, you'll see that those are my special characters. Now, we were already working with this font, but say we had not been, we may be looking at something like this. Okay, so when you paste in those special characters, you may get these little boxes. What that means is that you just need to select the font that you are working with. So don't panic if that happens to you. And once I have my special characters, I can just type in the rest. So there we go. So overall, not difficult. The hardest part is finding the glyphs that you want to use on the character map because they're so small. So it's completely up to you which way you go. Obviously, staying in Silhouette Studio is a lot easier, but if you're only using glyphs on occasion, then the glyphs panel may not be enough of a value to update to Designer Edition just yet. Now, I always encourage everyone to update, but you know, it's an investment. And if it's not features that you use that often, it may not be worth it to you. Now I'm going to show you a few examples that I have created using glyphs, and we will point out what the glyphs are, and you will be able to get a handle on how much glyphs can add value to a design. So here's an example of a design that I made using the glyphs and special characters. Now you'll recognize this is the font that we just used. So of course I used a glyph here and here on the right hand side. And these are part of the ornamentals that came with the font, as well as this TP right here. So all of those combined together really pull this design together so that it has a more appealing look, and it's something that more customers are going to want to purchase, whether they're crafters purchasing a design or whether they're purchasing finished merchandise from you. Here are some more designs that I made using that same font. And you'll see we used a combination of different types of introductory glyphs and also the exit glyphs over here on the right hand side. And then we mixed it up with a hand lettered font to round out the design itself. So I bundled these together because they all have the same look and feel, but each one is actually a little different. Now, this one is a different font that we used, and the glyphs are the opening here on Spice and the closing that includes the heart. So while this one isn't quite as ornamental, having the heart there definitely adds more character to this design and to that type of font. So let's wrap it up by talking about situations where you would want to use glyphs, but you may not be aware of them. So let me just type out silhouette. Now this will be true for a lot of different words that have double T's, double S's, a lot of times font designers, because this isn't always appealing, a lot of times font designers will have those letters written out in a better format. So this one in particular is called Lovely Buttering Script. And if you scroll all the way down to the bottom, I mean, you don't really want to ignore all these awesome glyphs, but if you scroll all the way down to the bottom, you'll see what I mean about the letters that they've written out that are separate from the normal double fonts. So the L's, the D's, TH, a lot of times ST, here's the SS. Here's the double T that I wanted to show you for an example though. So I can delete my T's, click on the double T's, and you have to admit that that looks much better. Here, let's look at them side by side. The glyph is much more appealing than the double T's side by side. So, you know, don't be afraid to check all the glyphs that you have, especially if you've purchased fonts, because font designers really, you know, they want you to use their fonts. They want their fonts to be popular, and they really put a lot of effort into it. And a lot of times you could be overlooking glyphs that you just don't know that they're there, even though you've been using the font for a while. So the textile panel or the character map on your PC are a really easy way to see if you have those glyphs, take a look at what they are, and incorporate them into your crafting.
So how do we feel about glyphs? They are a really, really neat feature. I love working with them in Silhouette Studio. And of course, you know, they just really add that extra pizzazz. They take my project from, hey, that's a good project, to wow, that is a really gorgeous project and I love the font you used. So 9 times out of 10, when people are looking for really script fonts for weddings, anniversaries, birthday cards, that sort of thing, they're always looking for those little extra characters. And now you watch the tutorial, you know how to get to them, you know what they can do, and you are all set to tackle these on your own. So if you have any questions or comments, make sure you leave them below, because we always come back in and check with you guys. And make sure you subscribe to the channel, because we do have a lot of really great videos for you right around the corner. So thanks for watching, guys. We'll see you next time.